So, good morning all of you. My name is Jyoti. I'm from SYBEd. My topic for today is event management, its concept, skill required and role of a teacher in event management. So my mentor was Professor Pratibha Dabhade Raisoni. She guided me. She checked my PPT and she gave me guidance how to do it. So now let's start with the presentation. So what is this concept of event management? So to understand event management, we need to understand project management. Project management is the process of leading the work of team to achieve a goal and meet success criteria at a specific time. So the primary challenge of project management is to achieve all the project goals within the given constraints. So this event management is a special case of project management. And basically what happens in these two things is there are many people involved in one task and we have to achieve that goal within given time. So event management is the application of project management to the creation and development of small and or large scale personal or corporate events such as festivals, conferences, ceremonies, wedding, formal parties, concerts or conventions. So we see these event management in our day-to-day life. So basically event management is everywhere. Whenever we are suppose we are taking a new home, so there is something when we are going to new home, we arrange some program, so we need to manage that event. So what happens in that? For example, if you go according to the definition, some people are involved in it and we have to achieve goal in the some fixed amount of time. So basically these two things are very important: coordination between the people and achieving the aim at given fixed point. So these are the example of events which we see in day-to-day life: wedding parties, cocktail, birthday parties, baby shower and all these things. So basically there are two types of event which we see in our day-to-day life. One is formal event and another is informal event. So these formal events are like which we see in our colleges and schools and like a press conference. All these things like celebrating Shiv Jayanti in school, celebrating some formal things. Means all these are examples of formal things which are celebrated generally in school and colleges and in conferences. If we see informal events in our day-to-day life, so this is something like baby shower, wedding, birthday party, and suppose you want to share your something happiness with your friends, so you might be arranging one party, so that is also an event.
Yes.
So let us go ahead. So these are the events which we see in school, like annual function, Independence Day, Sports Day. And this everyday activity like doing prayer every day means assembly, that is also an event. And this already we have discussed about this one, this event celebrating Shiv Jayanti, pic is shown. So now let us go to next. So what is skill required in event management? So we know that event management contains two main points. One is coordination between means social thing, means communication and coordination between people and achieving thing at a fixed amount of time, means at a certain instant that our event should be completed. So first thing for the coordination is required, that is communication skill. We should be able to communicate properly when our means if you want to coordinate with people, we need to communicate with people. Means we should be fluently in communication. There should be connection so that our information should flow. Like if you want flow of information from pen drive to laptop, there is some connection. So how connection is established between living things? So that mode is this communication skill. Next thing is calm under pressure. So many times in event it happens that there are some technical issues or something, some service is not going to be done at time. So we should not be panic at that time. you should be calm under this pressure. Next thing is problem solving. So suppose something doesn't go properly in event management, so we should be calm first, and after that we should think how we can solve this problem. After that, once we get solution for that problem, fourth thing, we should be firm to take that decision to apply that solution. Next thing is whenever we are arranging some, suppose we want to for an event for or anything, if you want to give some particular work to someone, first we see what is the experience of the person. Experience is very important, as important as degree, sometimes more important than degree. For example, like if we see monkey does not have any degree, but because of experience or something in that DNA, that monkey is able to apply law of gravitation and jump from one tree to another tree and take many different things. So experience give person ability to do something very skillfully. So as much as event we organize, we get experience how to deal with the things, different elements involved in event. So experience is one very important quality, important thing involved in event. Next one is flexibility. So suppose if we are not flexible, for example, there is a very big storm and the trees which are firm, they get broken down in the big storm, but the small grass which is flexible, because of its flexibility in big storm also, that small grass is still there. So whenever in event management also, suppose something is not going good, so we should not react, we should be flexible. So it's okay, we might say it's okay, let us do this. So we should be flexible will allow us to continue with the things even if something is not going in the way. Now next thing is listening. So in event management, suppose you are at a very high post and something from your little bit lower post want to say you something, that person see something and want to share with you something. So sometimes it happens that with the ego, person with in higher post does not listen to the person in the with little bit lower post. So we should not be like this. We should hear to that person what that person is saying. We should understand it, and we should, if that is a nice thing that person is saying, we should listen to that person and we should apply it to our event to make our event more successful. Now next thing is organized. So we see in event there are many, many things organized, like we have to do eating arrangement, we have to do stage arrangement, we have to do many, many arrangements. So we have to be a little bit organized about the things, and also the order in which the things should go, which thing should happen first and which thing should happen one after the another. In that way we should be organized. And next thing is passion. So that thing is means passion is very important. So even if the something goes not in our way, if we have passion, we does not leave it, we say no, I want to do it. Because of passion we continue things. So now let us go to next. So role of a teacher in event management. So we see basically we are concerned in event management in school and role of a teacher in event management when some event is happening in school. So first thing is to maintain coordination between different elements of event. So there are many, suppose there is event, so in that event many students are involved, many teachers are involved, and also housekeeping services are also involved. So there to carry out that event successfully, we should maintain coordination between these different elements, the teacher. After that, to assure that things go in correct sequence. So sometimes, so we need to give information to each and every element that after this element you are going to do it. So we should link these events so that there is correct sequence one after the another. There should be no gap when one event is happening. After that, to manage decoration part. So when a role of a teacher is very important when in decoration also. So like for example, when we was celebrating Shiv Jayanti, I was involved in decoration part in for the board. So a role of a teacher is also for the decoration part also in event management. Now if we see the fourth point, to do justice with the participants and results. So this happens many times in school. For example, when I was in school also, so the teacher used to take one student many times. Suppose there is no new student having less experience, less confidence. So that student try to attempt, but the teacher, because of partiality and getting impressed with one student, repeatedly allow one student to win. And also with the feeling that if that student with the more experience come participate, the chances of winning are more, and their house will get more points, and they will their house will like Ashoka house, Shivaji house, like these houses are there. And if that student, more experienced and smart student, if she allow, their house will win. So this should not happen. Teacher should go beyond that. Teacher should think the student with the more smartness is already developed so much. If she should respect the feeling of the student who is not that much means that much up to that with the experienced one. After some point, we may see that unexperienced one may go beyond the smarter one also. Maybe that unexperienced one may become more smarter than the initial smarter student. So we should think about the student, not about the winning of our house. And we should actually give all student one chance. Now let us go to next one. So fifth one is teacher need to guide student how to represent their content before the audience. So teacher is little bit experienced one. She has gone through a schooling process and now she is a teacher. So she has lot of experience. So if suppose there is one new student in the event, so she should guide that student how to represent the content because she has lot of experience. Now if you go to sixth point, teacher need to encourage student to do their best. So role of teacher in event management is also that. So sometimes student to make the student to perform to the student's best, she should encourage that student because teacher was at a point, she was also a student. So she know how that student might be feeling before going on stage. So she should encourage student to do that student's best. Now if you go to seventh point, if student is not feeling emotionally stable, teacher need to do counseling of the student. So this happened with many students that when they go on stage, some student get freezed. We need to sometimes unlock that freeze. So yeah, if this happen in school, it's okay, it's not a big deal. So we should first tell that student that we should first when we say go ahead, I am with you. So we should give that student feeling that if something not go on the way, don't worry, nothing will happen, just try your best, I'm with you. And it happens with many people, so don't worry much about it, just do means be natural, do whatever you are able to do, and do it from your heart. So that one is the very important role of a teacher for student in event management. Now if we go to eighth point, teacher needs to take follow up of the things involved in event. So sometimes what happens, teacher organized event very nicely, but at the last moment something goes missing, means some service is not available. So before that last moment, means before starting of the event, 1 or 2 hours before, she should take follow up which services are still alive now also, so that our event will go smoothly. So I'm done. So we have discussed about the concept and what are the skill required for event management and role of a teacher in event management. Thank you.
Hello, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. The topic for the seminar was event management, the concept, the skills, and role of a teacher in the event management. Okay. First of all, I congratulate you, Jyoti, because in a proper sequence, you have conducted the seminar. And you have covered various points. And I like what I like. You have correlated the project management with the event management. Okay. Before giving example of event management in the schools, you are given examples related to the household event management. And you also focus on the various skills. And what I like about you, while presenting, only the minimum content was showed on your presentation or in the PPT, we can say. Okay, so different skills required for the event management, you have explained very nicely. And lastly, you ended your seminar after telling what is the role of a teacher in the event management. Okay, now let me move towards the question answer session. Okay, so be ready for this. Yes, Jyoti?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so according to you, as a teacher, which is the most important thing which is really needed for the proper or successful implementation of the school event?
So I think most important thing will come from why we are conducting it. So why we are conducting it? It is for the students. So most important thing is we should involve more and more students in all the activities so that students will get experience, and whenever in life they will trying to conduct any event, they will not feel like, oh, I'm doing it for the first time, what will happen? So most important thing when some event is organized in school is try to involve more, all means if some part of student is involved in this event, try to involve new group of student in another event, and try to involve all the student one or the another event, and that is our ideal situation, that all student will get some or one or kind of the another experience from these events.
Okay, nice answer, Jyoti. The second question is, suppose we are going to held one event at our school, okay, like a sport event is there, and you are the event manager for that particular event, okay, so how you can manage each and everything?
Okay, so suppose there is a sports event in our school, so first it will be introduced in our assembly that, or now these are online things it is not possible in during COVID-19, so it is possible in regular school. So yes, in regular school there is assembly, so in assembly first it will be informed to all the students that there will be a sports event in our school, so whoever are interested please participate. So we will be giving some particular time and date that for these, so we need to make one timetable that students which are interested in this sport, please come to this ground at this time on this day. So once student, and this information should reach all the students first in the assembly. Next, we can put it in soft copy on WhatsApp, like there are some WhatsApp group for the schools. So once our information reach the student, we will organize we will first make that arrangement, like making white lines on the ground, and then putting making available all the sports equipments which are necessary to conduct that event, and we will we will organize that those things without partiality. Means sometimes it happens that means if there are many students, teacher means there is some means when we are looking from different angle, the means result is not fair. We should be arranging such that the first student should be first only. Sometimes what happens, the middle students even appears to be running fast than the students at the corner. They go away from our range of eye. So this should not happen. We should with justice conduct all the events, and once we got first, second, third, we will distribute prizes for that student again in the assembly.
Okay, so you were tell the answer that as you are the event manager of that particular event, but what are the roles of the other teachers and the, what we can say the role of the other non-teaching staff also in the event management, because it is the event and it is not conducted by the single person, is not only responsible for the conduction of the event.
So to get it more organized, what we can do, we can tell all the class teachers, please give the data of the student who are interested from your class in this sports. So once we will get this data from all the classes, it will be easy to see how much is the crowd. Sometimes what happens, crowd is lot more than the expectation. So our management fails. So this is good idea to first tell class teacher, please give data how many students are going to come from your class. After that, we can include class teacher also if the crowd is lot more. So see, at that time those students are going to be on the ground, so that particular period teacher can come with the students on the ground to maintain discipline and to help the event manager to help in other things if necessary.
Okay, I think Jyoti, good try for giving answers, but I think the most important factor while event planning, that in the event management, that is nothing but the planning. Okay, so what comes under the planning? So first, there should be meeting with the other teachers and with the principal or who is the head of that particular school, and there we supposed to finalize the which kind of sports events we are going to conduct on that particular day. There should be finalization of the activity, and after that you can assign the task. Okay, just show me the slide where you have showed us the skills required for the event manager. Just move on that. Yes, okay, so these are the skills required in event management, and what you can say, of course these are the skills required, but who is the main person, that is the event manager, the particular person who is leading the taking leadership for the conduction of or for the planning of the particular event, that is nothing but the event manager. Okay, so first of all there should be planning. Planning of the particular event. Okay. So then there will be a meeting with the another staff member. So we can say the principal or the head of the particular school. Then in that meeting, we'll finalize the activity, which activity and when it is possible, so that it is possible for the parents also. They are having holidays. So it is easy to make the crowd for that particular event. Okay. Otherwise, what will happen? Your event will be fail. So everything you are going to decide in the meeting regarding that particular event, that is nothing but the planning. Then the next is organized. Okay, so that is one skill, the particular person for event management, there should be proper organization, or it should be organized. Organized means what?
Ma'am, the way you said from the starting means if we go in principals, if we decide everything in the principal's room, it is very clear to everybody that what we have to do, and it is very important thing, means we have to follow it. So suppose whatever I say and whatever is decided before principal, principal is having more power. In the starting only if I do it, the things are automatically going to be too much organized.
Yes, and here we are to you supposed to take care of not only of the human resources, means who are taking care of the different tasks, but also we have to take care of the material resources which are required for the conduction of the particular event. If the particular school is not having that much resources, you have to think about the purchasing of that resources, right? Okay,
yes,
the next thing, suppose we are going to hold different competitions regarding the sports. Okay, so at that time you may require, so who is going to judge that particular activity or the particular competitions? So that also comes under the planning. If you are inviting other person for judging particular competitions, so you have to communicate with that particular person. And again, in the planning, you are allocating different tasks to the different teachers and among the different non-teaching staff also. Okay. Just move on. This is the experience. Okay, so what is role experience? It is a skill which is required for the event management. So what you can tell us about this experience? Yes.
Can you repeat your question, ma'am?
See, this is one skill which is required for the event management, right? So you have written here that is experience. Experience, it is important. Yes. Okay, yes. So can you give example related to this, that is experience?
Okay, so suppose we are event and project, we have seen that event is special case of project. So suppose there is very big project going in a company, so that what that person sees, how, or suppose a recent experience which I saw, that getting affiliation from CBSE for a school. So okay. When they are trying to get affiliation for a CBSE in a school, so they are looking at a person who has already successfully given affiliation to a school from CBSE. So they see how much experience, means that person has already gone through that process. That person is always is having more experience, means that person is having all the views, all the angles and all the possibilities. Where the means we have more experience, then the chances of getting success is more, because we know all the points where the things go wrong and why that affiliation get declined. So experience is proportional to, means success is proportional to the experience. Success of an event is proportional to the experience of that person.
See, here we are only talking about the event management. So whatever example given by you, that is affiliation of your school related to CBSE board. Okay, means you want CBSE affiliation from the CBSE board. So that is not the relevant example, because here we are talking about the event management. So whatever event you are going to conduct at our school, here we are talking about that event management. So your experience means what?
During this COVID-19, this thing happened in school. So if I see that affiliation, getting affiliation from CBSE, so it appears to me as an event only, because in that thing, all the staff was involved, principal, teaching staff, and means everything. And we have to do it within certain amount of time. So according to the definition, it looks to me as an event only, means we have to arrange all these things, welcoming that person, and then from
means you want to say that there are some members, they are going to visit your school for the affiliation.
Yes.
so that you are considering this particular, that is affiliation. So what will be the name for that particular event?
Getting affiliation for the school.
Yes, they simply, you can say the school affiliation, that can be the event. So you plan for that. Okay, so there are certain, so there, I think initially there was a meeting, and in the meeting you plan, the head of the school, the principal, or you can say the headmaster, he plan along with the teaching and non-teaching staff. So what we are going to do on the particular day, and he allocated different tasks among you, among the teachers and non-teaching staff as well. Okay, and you work whatever task given to you. See, the experience means what? For example, and see, there are different skills, they are interrelated. For example, organization, even the experience. So whenever the particular teacher is good in handwriting, the particular teacher is good in the communication. Okay, so as per the talent that particular person is having, or the particular teacher is having, accordingly the principals, or we can say the higher authority or any HOD, they're going to allocate the task to the concerned person. Okay.
Yes.
Maybe that is based on the experience. Okay. And it also comes under the organization. Means organization means what? There we have to consider about the human and the material resources, and the proper person should be at the right place. Means the particular person is having the good certain skills, then the same task should be given to that, so that that task will be very effective. Okay, that is nothing but the experience. Now what about the flexibility? See, there is relation between the communication, between the listening also, because communication, it should be always two-way communication. Means someone is sending the information and others is receiving the same information. That is there should not be gap between the communication, and it is possible when there is only single authority. मीन्स बहुत बार क्या होता है, एक टीचर स्टूडेंट को एक बोलता है, दूसरा दूसरा टीचर दूसरे कुछ बोलता है, तीसरा टीचर. सो हियर व्हाट वी आर डूइंग, वी आर एलोकेटिंग द पर्टिकुलर टास्क टू द क्लास टीचर, सो द सेम मैसेज रिसीव्ड बाय द स्टूडेंट्स. ओके, मीन्स समटाइम्स वी आर अगेन फॉलोइंग द स्केलर चेन इन द कम्युनिकेशन. ओके, एंड द वॉट एवर, सी of course there is a event manager, particular person is the event manager, but here we are allocating different tasks to others also. So for that particular sub task, they are the leaders. Okay, and
yes,
so here the leader should listen carefully. So whatever the followers are saying, means they can be the students, they can be the parents, or whatever, maybe they are giving us any guidelines. Maybe they are providing us their views about the organization of the particular event. So here there should be the good listener, the event manager, not only the event manager, but the others who are the part of that particular event. Means they should be the good listener. Okay. Then just move on the previous slide, slide number 9. Yes, Jyoti. Okay. Communication skill, calm under pressure, problem solving and decision making. Okay, so we have completed the communication skill. The calm under pressure means what?
Means sometimes when we are conducting one event, sometimes things doesn't go the way we want.
Yes, so, actually as for the planning. Yes,
yes. So there is little bit pressure. Now how it is a chain, so if previous thing break down, next thing get affected. So yes, sometimes whole thing goes very bad because of that thing. So we should not, suppose one thing doesn't go that way which way we want, so we should be calm. There is actually pressure on that that event manager, but yes, that under that pressure, that event manager should be calm, so that he can apply his brain and he can take some decision to cover that whatever wrong thing has gone.
Okay, and can you give me any one example related to problem solving and decision making?
Okay, so sometimes some technical problem happens during one event management. Sometimes that teacher is using, suppose, Microsoft, and that Microsoft at last moment is not working. So what that teacher can do, so instead of struggling with Microsoft, she can use another app, Zoom app, and she can carry out forward things using Zoom.
Okay, that is correct example. But I think suppose we are using Microsoft, and maybe there is a issue with the system, and maybe there is a issue with the internet, or you can say electricity issue. So at that time, we have to think before, in the planning only, we have to think about these issues. Maybe there may be chances of electricity or no electricity. Okay, whenever the event is there. Maybe there is a chances of hanging of the system, we can say. Okay, so always as a event manager, we should have the another option with us. Okay,
yes.
For example, just now you gave example, suppose the Zoom, this Micro MS Team platform is not working, there is a problem with the system, so we can move on the another platform. Okay, so that is the another option. In case of electricity, we should have the backup. Yes.
Yeah.
Even in case of the, suppose we are using the Wi-Fi, but suddenly there may be chances of what you can say, that there is a chances of low bandwidth. So automatically the connection is down. So at that time we should have the another option, that is modem. modem with us, so we can use that modem, and there is a internet. That is the second option for the internet connectivity. So as an event manager, we should have always, we should think about the another option. Maybe they it will be needed or it will not. ओके उसकी जरूरत पड़ भी सकती है नहीं भी पड़ सकती बट अगर आपका इवेंट क्योंकि कोई भी प्रॉब्लम वो आपको बता के नहीं आता सडनली वो प्रॉब्लम आपके सामने आ जाता है सो एट दैट टाइम सी हियर इज ऑल्सो सी दीज आर ऑल्सो रिलेटेड टू ईच अदर द काम अंडर द प्रेशर सो वेन एवर देर इज अ प्रॉब्लम मे बी देर आर चांसेस ऑफ getting pressure there is a pressure on the shoulders of the event manager even from on the head of the that particular school okay and there is a problem solving so at that the right decision should be taken by the concerned person so that is the thing okay so very nicely you have conducted and the question answer session or we can say the debate session it was also nice okay any other questions from the other students yes Archana Smita I think Archana she joined lately Smita
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Archana, say something. Have you understood about this topic? This is very simple and this is very interesting topic.
Yes, ma'am. Everything was clear.
Okay, good, Smita. Yes, Archana, what about you?
Just now I am in, ma'am.
Why you are late today?
Ma'am, because of some problem is there. That's why.
Okay. Okay, no issues. I have recording of this seminar, so you can just go through recording also. We'll share the link of this recording on the group. So just go through it and you can understand the entire topic. Okay, I think the many students, they are busy with the submissions and we are having prelims also in the next weeks. So all the best for your prelim examination. Start working, start preparing MCQs because in the final examination also, the pattern of examination, that is MCQ test only, MCQ exam only. So please start working on that. Whenever you are reading any kind of material regarding any theoretical subjects, just whatever main things are there, just highlight the things, and you can just write main points on the whatever blank side is there on the page, you can write on that. Okay, so start working. Don't be panic. You will get good marks in your prelim examination, but the hard work and the consistency is very much needed for giving any kind of examinations. So all the very best to you all. Okay, thank you so much. Thank you, Jyoti.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, should I end up this meeting or you have some queries regarding the topic or any other thing? Yes?
No.
Yes, okay. Archana, Smita, no?
No.
Ma'am. Oh, okay, okay then. Thank you. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself and your family. See you soon. Bye-bye.
Yes. Bye, ma'am. Thank you.